Okay, so welcome back to my channel, you guys. I do have my August favorites. This past month, you guys, I kind of got a lot of makeup. Like, I have a lot to share with you guys, so I'm really excited to jump right into it. And before we do start, make sure you go ahead and like and subscribe, and let's jump right into the video. Okay, so the first set of products are all from BH Cosmetics because they did send me some products this month, so I do have a lot of favorites from what they sent. The first one I do want to talk about is their Paradise Refresh Face Mist, and this is a refreshing spray. This stuff is so good, you guys. Like, when it comes to setting sprays, I do love the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist, but this one is a little bit better. Like, I'm not sure what it does, but when I spray it on the face, it sets your makeup. It makes it look skin-like, but it also kind of mattifies it at the same time, but adds a little bit of glow as well. Y'all see what I mean? Like, it's everywhere, but it just makes your skin look absolutely perfect. And also, when it comes to the setting mist itself, it is super fine and light, and I love that. So this one really shocked me because when I first got it, I just didn't know what to expect from it, but y'all, I have been obsessed ever since. Now, moving on to the next one, I do have the BH Cosmetics Paradise Prime Mattifying Face Primer, which is this right here. And this is super cute, you guys. I love the whole theme that's going on. So actually, funny enough, when it comes to the primer itself, I really love it for the mattifying effect. But what I really love about this primer is when it comes to my problem areas that have, you know, issues with foundation staying on, which is my nose typically, this gives it a nice base because I noticed once I put this on my nose and then I apply my foundation, it just looks absolutely flawless. And I'm not sure what it is about the nose, but I have a hard time getting a smooth base on there, but with this I have no issue, you guys, and it's just so good. And one thing I do want to show you guys as well is what it looks like. It doesn't have that silicone texture to it, which I really like, but y'all can see what it looks like right here. Super nice, and just it blends right into the skin. So I really, really do love this primer. Now, moving on to the next one I do love from them as well. It's a BH Cosmetics Vanilla Cherry Truffle 4-Color Blush Palette, which is this right here. Super, super cute. Now, one thing about this blush palette I love is the way it smells. Like, every time I open it, you guys, I low-key have to sniff it because it smells like a pastry, like, candy shop, if that makes sense. But it just smells really, really good, and this is what it looks like as well. And these colors are women of color friendly, as y'all can tell, super rich and pigmented. And the two I've been using lately is these two right here, over here. These are the two that I use all the time, but these are super pigmented. They're buttery on the skin, but honestly, this blush palette has been my favorite as of lately because it's super buttery and pigmented, and there's so many colors to pick from. It is just so beautiful. Now, I do have one more product from BH Cosmetics, and it's a rose quartz 9-piece brush set. Hopefully y'all can see this, but their brushes are so bomb, you guys. Like, I used to use, well, I still use the Morphe brushes, but Morphe brushes is all I know because they're super nice and affordable, and they're great quality as well. But I didn't know BH Cosmetics was like killing it when it came to their brushes, because when I tried this on my face, y'all, I was shook. I didn't expect them to be so nice and just soft. Like, hopefully y'all can see it, but they're super soft and dirty as well because I've been using them all week. But these are really nice, and I did not expect that. So if you're looking for some nice brushes, you guys, definitely check them out because they have a lot of options to pick from online, and they're just really good quality, and they're not expensive at all as well. All right, so now moving on to a different brand, I do have the Laura Mercier Translucent Loose Setting Powder in the shade Honey. This powder, you guys, honestly blew me out the park, and I know I've mentioned this a couple times if you've seen all my videos on this, but with this powder, I was sitting there one day thinking, you know, if Laura Mercier came out with a yellow setting powder, it'll be over. Like, it'll be over because their setting powders are super nice and fine, and they're probably one of the best out there in the market because it's super light and airy on the skin. So let me go ahead and take this out for you guys and show you what it looks like. And like I mentioned before, I'm gonna hold it all the way back here because when I bring it up close, y'all can't really see the color, but it's a beautiful yellow powder. And also, my main thing about this powder that I love is the fact that once you put it on your skin, it doesn't alter the color of your concealer, because a lot of setting powders nowadays, if they're super yellow, it'll kind of change the color and all of that. This just sets the under eyes, but it also brightens it a little bit as well. It's just a really beautiful powder, so I highly, highly recommend this. And for everybody out there who picked this up because of my review, everyone told me they loved it, so y'all just have to trust me as well. Okay, so we only have a couple more products left, and one of them is Juno & Co. Moonshine Miracle Cream. First of all, y'all, the packaging. All right, the packaging I am living for because it's so different and unique. And let me go ahead and open it up for you guys as well. But Juno was so kind to send this to me just to test out and let me know what I think about it. And I'm sure y'all can't see what it looks like in here because it's super white. But regardless, I have heard so many good things about this for a year or two now, actually. So when it comes to this product, the main thing is it's supposed to give you a flawless base before you go ahead and apply your foundation. You can wear it by itself or you can wear it alongside a primer as well. Put your foundation on and everything looks really nice and smooth. And I've tried it for about 2 weeks now, you guys, and I freaking love this thing because I've just heard about it for such a long time and I've always wanted to try it out. So when Juno told me they were sending me this, I freaked out, you guys. Like, I was like, y'all, like, I cannot wait to tell you my thoughts on this. So it's been 2 weeks now and I really love this product if you want to go ahead and have a nice base before you put your foundation on. And also, I'm not sure if I did mention this to you guys, but when it comes to this, I don't use a moisturizer beforehand because it is a cream and a primer in one, so you really don't need both. But I do have a coupon code for you guys if you do want to try it out and save a little bit of money, which I will put right here. So make sure you go ahead and check it out. All right, so last but not least, I feel like this whole entire month everyone's been asking me the lip combo I've been wearing as of lately, specifically my lip gloss combo. So I did want to go ahead and share with you guys. All right, so starting with the first thing that's very, very important, which is my lip liner. I've been using the Morphe Trendsetter lip liner, which kind of reminds me of Cork from MAC, but this is a lot cheaper, you guys. I think I probably paid like $5 for this, so it is super, super cheap, and I do have it on my lips today as well for reference. Now for the actual glosses that I use, this combo I have on my lips currently is the BH Cosmetics Serena Liquid Lipstick times the Fenty Beauty Hot Chocolate Gloss Bomb. So what I do is I go ahead and apply the lip liner all over, put the liquid lipstick in the center, and then apply this gloss bomb on top, and I'm good to go, and you will get this combo right here. Now let's say you don't want a liquid lipstick. I do have another option that I was using beforehand. I do have the Morphe Backstage Lip Gloss, which is a nice brown lip gloss, you guys. I love this so, so much. It is so pretty. And then on top of that, in the center, what I do put is the Anastasia Vintage Lip Gloss as well. So what I do is I go ahead and put the Morphe lip liner all over, and then I put the Morphe Backstage Lip Gloss all over as well. And then in the center, I use the Anastasia Vintage Lip Gloss in the center. And this has been my combo as of lately. So for everyone who's been asking, I hope I answered all you guys, you know, comments that their request for this lip combo, but this is what I've been using as of lately and I just love it. Like, it's so pretty. All right, you guys, so that was my whole entire August favorites. I do hope you enjoyed this video, and like always, let me know down below your thoughts and also products that you did love as well. Let me know down below, but I love you guys so much. Make sure you go ahead and like, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.